this is a solution.
Sam Stoop and his team at the Institute for Bio-Nanotechnology and Medicine at Northwestern University are developing revolutionary ways to treat broken bones and damaged tissue. They want to make the use of hardware in the body a relic of medical history.
Instead of using these parts, then maybe there is a very high non-invasive injection of something by non-invasive surgery that causes the bone to regrow very rapidly. Or let's say if you're missing a piece of cartilage in your knee joint, and cartilage is a tissue that unfortunately, once we turn 18, it doesn't regenerate spontaneously. So the question is, can we use some new capabilities to cause that cartilage to grow in adults? That would really transform medical practice.
A non-invasive injection that'll cause bones and tissue to regrow? Sounds bionic, but it is a reality. Stoop has even found a way to regenerate damaged tissue in the central nervous system, the brain and spinal cord, something the body cannot do on its own.
So that's where my nanofibers come in. We have found a way, by self-assembly, to make these very smart molecules that when they find each other in a glass of water, they come together into nanofibers. And these fibers were designed to talk to cells in our bodies and essentially tell them, look, I know that you normally don't regenerate, but we are here to tell you that you should.
One type of cell that Stoop's nanofibers talk to are neurocells, which are like electrical cables connecting the brain to the body's limbs. When neurocells in the spinal cord are broken, the brain's connection to the limbs is broken. The result is paralysis. But Stoop's nanofibers send broken neurocells a signal to regenerate, and miraculously, they do.
Using biological knowledge, we thought rationally, what type of fiber could make them do that? And so we went to the lab and actually designed the molecule, and also designed it so that it would become a fiber, a tiny fiber.
The next challenge was to design a delivery system for these magical nanofibers. Stoop and his colleagues developed a special gel. The gel is formed into sac-like structures which hold the nanofibers in place. The gel also degenerates and leaves the body once the regeneration of tissue is complete. One of Professor Stoop's assistants is Ramil Capito.
As far as regenerating tissue, if we can have the gel stay where we want it to stay and then control its degradation over time, so we need to regenerate and degrade sort of simultaneously, or else you won't have a good tissue.
The creation of smart molecules that self-assemble into nanofibers, which in turn send signals to damaged cells to regenerate, the development of the gel to hold these nanofibers in place, and the actual process of tissue regeneration, all of this took years of lab work and testing in animals.
It's difficult because we really need to show safety and efficacy, especially when we're injecting materials in the body. And so going through the FDA, doing the necessary clinical trials, and seeing that it is, you know, efficacious, you know, that takes a long time. And I think the science, you know, we can discover something in a day, but we have to be lucky. But it's actually taking that discovery and actually putting it through the process it needs to go through to actually get to a patient. That's what takes long.
The payoff for human patients should come within a decade. Stoop hopes that in 5 years, spinal cord paralysis will become a thing of the past. Stoop's regenerative process works for bones as well. Bones will regenerate naturally when fractures are small. However, when the space between fractured parts is too great, regeneration will not occur. But when Stoop's gel is injected to fill in the gap between the broken bones, the nanofibers work their magic and new bone grows into place.
Bone regeneration and cartilage regeneration are particularly important for elderly people. So this would keep quality of life very high for that population.
In addition to tissues and bones, Stoop and his colleagues are working on regenerating organs of the body, including the heart. In the process, they're creating thousands of different nanofibers, customizing each one to the tissue or organ they're trying to regenerate. Can nanotechnology create solutions for every problem we face?
From a science standpoint, it's absolutely amazing. There is a surprise every day. I've given up thinking we can't do anything, right?